Dear friends, welcome to another project video. Today we're going to modify this analog voltmeter and convert it into an analog thermometer using Arduino and a DS18B20 temperature sensor. Without any further delay, let's get started. Hey guys, I am Nick and welcome to Educates TV, a channel that is all about do-it-yourself electronics projects with Arduino, Raspberry Pi, ESP8266 and other popular boards. You can subscribe to our channel by clicking on this button. Today we're going to learn how to use this analog voltmeter with Arduino and make it show the temperature instead of the voltage. As you can see, in this modified voltmeter, we can see the temperature in degrees Celsius. The temperature is measured by this digital sensor, a DS18B20, and it is then displayed on the voltmeter. I really like analog dials like this one because they give a vintage look to the projects. Let's now see how to achieve this result. The parts that we're going to need today are the following: an Arduino Uno, a DS18B20 temperature sensor, a DC analog voltmeter with a range from 0 to 5 volts, and some wires. The cost of the project is around $9. You can find links for all the parts I use in the description of the video below. At first, let's see how to control the voltmeter with Arduino. We connect the positive side of the voltmeter to digital pin 9 and the negative one to ground. Since the Arduino Uno does not offer a digital to analog converter, we have to use one of the PWM pins in order to write an analog value to a digital pin of the Arduino. Pulse width modulation is a technique for getting analog results with digital means. Instead of writing high to the digital pin, with PWM we send a pulse. PWM is attached to certain pins of the Arduino Uno. Those digital pins that support PWM have this symbol next to them. In order to send a value to the voltmeter, we use the analog write command and we write a value from 0 to 255. So, if we write 0, the voltmeter shows 0 volts, and if we write 255, the voltmeter shows 5 volts. We can write any other value between 0 and 255, and the voltmeter needle will go to the appropriate position. So, if we want the voltmeter to show 2.5 volts, we have to call the command analogWrite 9128. Great! Now we can control the voltmeter needle at will. Let's now convert the voltmeter into a thermometer. First, we have to connect the DS18B20 sensor. We connect the pin with the minus sign to Arduino ground, the pin with the plus sign to 5 volts, and the signal pin to digital pin 2. That's it. Now we have to prepare the panel meter. I unscrew these screws and I remove this metal plate. We then need to design our own face for it. I designed a simple one using Photoshop. Actually, designing the face took me much more time than building the project itself, so in order to save your time, I will attach the file in the description of the video. Now, all we have to do is to print the face for the panel meter and glue it in place. If we load the code and power up the project, we can see that it works fine. If I touch the sensor, the temperature rises quickly. Our analog thermometer is ready. Let's now take a quick look at the code of the project in order to understand how it works. We need the Dallas temperature library in order the code to compile. The code is very simple. We first read the temperature from the sensor. Next, we pass the temperature value to the temperature to PWM function. This function converts the temperature to a PWM value from 0 to 255 using the map function. Next, all we have to do is to write this PWM value out at the voltmeter. You can also define the maximum and the minimum temperature that your panel meter can display by changing the values of these variables. The smaller the gap between these two values, the bigger the resolution the panel meter will offer. As always, the code of the project can be found in a link in the description of the video. I really love the looks of these analog panel meters, so I am going to build a lot of projects with them. In a future video, I will design and 3D print a vintage enclosure for this analog thermometer we built today. I am going to use an Arduino Nano to make things more compact and add some yellow diffused LEDs to illuminate the panel at night. I think it will be cool. I would love to hear your opinion about this. Do you like analog panel meters? And if yes, what kind of projects are you going to build using one of these? Please post your comments in the comment section below, and of course, don't forget to like the video if you find it interesting. Thanks! If you are new to the channel, I would love to have you subscribed by clicking on the channel icon here, because every Saturday I post a new video about do-it-yourself electronics and robot projects. I hope you will join our community. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build!